بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. So alhamdulillah we finish ilm al maani, we finish ilm al bayan. And ilm al bayan consists of the three sections. Majaz, two sections, majaz and kinaya. And in majaz we had a whole taqseem. Okay, now we're moving on to ilm al badi'. I told you before that ilm al badi' is embellishments, meaning how do you beautify and how do you make the kalam look better, sound better, appear better. And so these are called, these embellishments are called what, muhassinat, things which cause beauty, which create beauty. And there are two types of muhassinat. Okay, one that relates to the lafz, meaning the word itself, the way it's written, the way it's pronounced, it has a beauty to it. And the second part is the ma'na, muhassinatun ma'nawiyya, those muhassinat, those things which create beauty because of the meaning. And you understand as you go along, inshallah. So first, muhassinat lafziyya. So first, very simple. Let's say bara'atul istihlal. Istahalla yastahillu istihlalan means to start, to initiate. And bara'a means bari', wonderful, great, splendid. So you start something in a really like wonderful way. And a beautiful example is Surah Isra. Subhanalladhi asra bi'abdihi. So Allah starts off with what? Subhana. Surah Fatiha? Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Many surah. Alhamdulillahi alladhi nazal furqan ala abdihi. So you start off the surah, obviously it's Quran, but obviously this also applied to before in Jahiliyyah and their poetry. So in poems or whatever, you start off something which just straight away draws your imagination, straight away it just creates this wow factor. That's called bara'atul istihlal. Okay, so glorious is he who made a servant go from Baytullah, from Makkatul Mukarrama all the way to Masjid Al-Aqsa, it is a portion of the night. Subhanallah, Subhanalladhi asra bi'abdihi. So it starts off with this great imagination capturing scene. Okay, another example, Husnul Khitam. So Bara'atul Istihlal, you start off beautifully, and Husnul Khitam is what? You finish it off in a beautiful way. For example, Wa akhiru da'wahum alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. The last thing that finished off, the last thing that they will say in Jannah is what? Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Not the end of the surah, but the end of the saying. So you see, it has a very nice ending. And that's why, for example, the Kafatul Majlis, you finish off the Majlis with what? Subhanallah, bihamdihi, subhanakallahumma, bihamdika, wa nashhadu la ilaha illa anta, wa nastaghfiruka, wa natubu ilayk. Imam Bukhari, rahmatullah, you finish off the kitab with what? Subhanallah, bihamdihi, subhanallah, al-azim. It has so much fa'ida in that. So this is called Husnul Khitam. You finish it off in a nice way. Right. Now this is something a bit, this is called Raddu Sadri ala al-Ajzi. Sadr means what? Literally chest or beginning. And the Ajz means the back or the ending. So basically, you start and end with the same theme. So basically, you're turning back the chest onto the back. Literally, it doesn't really make much sense. But in a linguistic form, it means what? To finish off what you started with. For example, look. وَتَخْشَ النَّاسِ وَاللَّهُ أَقْوَانِ. What do you start off with? Takhsha. You finish off with? Takhsha. You fear the people, but who should you fear more? Allah. So what you start off with, that's the sadr. That's the ajz. So you return or bring back the beginning at the end. You see? Yeah. This can happen in the whole surah as well. For example, Surah Noon. Noon wal qalami wa ma yasturun ma anta bi ni'mati rabbika bi majnun. Allah started off the surah saying what? The people are calling you mad. Na'udhu billahi min dhalik. You are not mad. إِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمًا. Allah goes on and mentions the great character of Prophet ﷺ. And then at the end of the surah, Allah remarks the same topic again. وَيَقُولُونَ إِنَّهُ لَمَجْنُونَ. And again, they're saying what? That you are mad. إِنُّ وَمَا هُوَ إِلَّا ذِكْرٌ لِلْعَالَمِينَ. So in the previous ayah, you start the ayah with one theme, وَتَخْشَ النَّاسِ. And you finish off the same theme, وَاللَّهَ أَكْوَانْ تَخْشَى. And here, you can also have in the whole surah, or the whole conversation, the whole topic. You start off with one thing, that what? You are not mad. You finish off the same topic. وَمَا أَنْتَ وَإِنَّهُ يَقُولُونَ إِنَّهُ لَمَجْنُونَ. The same topic. So starting off the same theme and finishing off with the same theme. Another form is, this is called saja. And within this beginning I explained to you, is that each sentence ends in a similar pattern. For example, Surah Taha. مَا أَنْزَلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْقُرْآنَ لِتَشْقَى إِلَّا تَذْكِرَةً لِمَنْ يَخْشَى تنزيلا ممن خلق الأرض والسماوات العلى الرحمن ولا العرش استوى له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض ما بينهما ما تحت الثرى. The whole surah or majority of the surah has this what? It ends in the same pattern. It's called saja, rhyme, a rhythm.
like Surah
Rahman. Surah Rahman as well. Yeah. فبأي آلاء ربك ذبان. It ends in the an theme. Okay. So it's very simple. I mean, it's something. When you get used to Arabic, you can write. You got to write things like this. That's a long way off. Inshallah, Allah make you reach there one day. Poetry as well. Okay. Jinas. What does jins mean? General, or also means a group. They're all from one group. So jinas means what? That you have two words. They're similar. They seem from the same jins. So, like example here, this ayah. وَيَوْمَ تَقُومُ السَّاعَةُ يُقْسِمُ الْمُجْرِمُونَ مَا لَبِثُوا غَيْرَ سَاعَةً. So the first as-sa'ah and the second sa'ah, they look similar, don't they? But they have different meanings. يَوْمَ تَقُومُ السَّاعَةُ, the day, the hour, which hour? Qiyamah. When Qiyamah will be established, what would they say? We only stayed for an hour. It feels that we only stayed in dunya for how long? Couple of minutes, 1 hour. So even though they're both the same, they look similar. But they both have different meanings. One is to do with Qiyamah, one is to do with hour. It's called jinas, and this can go into a lot of details, a lot of types of these. But a basic one is this, that you have what? Two words that look similar, but they have different meanings. Do you understand? Qalb. What does qalb mean? Heart. And why do you call a heart a heart? Why do you call your heart a heart? Qalb literally means to turn over. So it can turn very easily. That's why you call the qalb qalb. It can turn very easily from hidayah to dhalalah. From hub to bughs. So that's why it's called qalb. So qalb, this is so qalb means you have such a sentence where you can read it from the front to the back and the back to the front. So look, kullu fi falakin yasbahun. Kaf, lam, fa, ya, fa, lam, kaf. Kullu fi falakin. Kullu fi falakin. Subhanallah. There's a book called Al-Maqamat Al-Haririyah. Maqamat Al-Hariri. So in here, he's actually got some poems. Not only two words, like the whole poem, like about 8-9 lines. You can read it this way, or you can read it that way. And the whole thing goes across. And about 8-9 poems like this. That book is amazing. He done a lot of... it's called Al-Maqamat Al-Haririyah. Okay. We've studied that in the Darulums. It's high level Arabic, a lot of vocabulary in it. One chapter, he has for the first half, every single word has a dot. He only uses like ba, ta, tha, ji. He won't use ha. He won't use dal. He won't use seen. So every single word, letter, has a dot. And then the next chapter, or next half of the chapter, every single word is not a single dot. So you can, the Arabic language is amazing. Yeah? So that's what you call muhassanat, lafziyah. You got it? Subhanallah, bihamdi, subhanakallahumma, wa bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, wa astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.